Very good day and welcome to all of you back again for our Saturday interactions. It's becoming a little warm now in Bangalore. I don't know which cities you are in and how the weather is there, but that's how life is. Weathers keep changing, climate keeps changing. We have to keep adapting. We have to respect nature. But today I'm not going to talk about respecting nature. I'm going to be talking about respecting relationships. I've already been emphasizing quite a bit on the fact that there is no other single factor that determines our well-being, happiness, fulfillment as good relationships. The one factor that contributes most towards your feeling of contentment, peace, joy is having good relationship, because we are basically social animals. We thrive on social contact. Okay. Now, what do relationships depend on? One is that there is a myth. You think that, you know, if you love a person, the relationship is good. The more you love a person, the better is the relationship. No, that is not true. Love is an emotion. It goes up, it goes down. It can change even momentarily. So if A says, I love B, it doesn't mean anything. It only means that at that moment, the person is going through this particular emotion called love. That love can turn to anger, irritation, even hatred, and it can again come back to love. But if A can say, I have a deep regard and respect for B, that is when you know that this relationship is going to stand the test of time, and this relationship is going to be a long-term relationship, and it will truly give you the type of satisfaction. There are people who are in loving relationships, but still they are not very happy with each other. Because like I said, love is just an emotion, and there are so many other emotions mixed up with love. So while you're feeling love, you may also have envy. You may also have some irritation against the person. You may have so many things. But respect, that is something which doesn't come and go. You cannot say that morning I respected this person, afternoon I don't respect him, evening I respect him again a lot. No. Respect is something which builds up over a time, and it builds up based on what is the interaction, what is the behavior, how the other person is, what you like and dislike. So you take your time, and over a period of time, you say, out of so many different people, this one person I hold in high regard. This person I look up to. This person I respect. And also remember, I'm not talking about that traditional respect, which says, respect your elders, or in an office setup, respect your boss and all that. No, that's a very artificial thing. What I am talking about is respecting the qualities of that person, respecting the character of that person, respecting the behavior of that person. So when you feel touched, you feel enamored, you feel impressed with the type of characteristics, the type of personality, the type of behavior that the person has, you develop this thing called respect. It could even be your child, for example. If your child shows maturity, if your child shows concern for you, if your child upholds the best of values, you can start respecting your child. And that has much, much greater strength in the long run than just saying, I love my child. So that is why I took up this topic today. That is, that respect builds close relationships, sustains close relationships, and enhances close relationships. So let's start with something, you know, very, very basic. Let's just, in very simple terms, define. Respect means that you accept somebody for who they are. Even when they are different from you or you don't agree with them. I do not agree with this person on 1, 2, 3, 4 things, but yet I respect the fact that this person doesn't cheat. This person is not a hypocrite. This person doesn't put me down. This person has different views. And I still respect this person. Respect in your relationship builds feelings of trust, safety, well-being, and eventually into commitment towards that relationship. And that is why I say that, you know, it's a very, very strong thing. So the first thing we should do is ask ourselves, whoever it is, mentally just list out who are your close people whom you value most. Ask yourself, what am I doing to gain the respect of this person? Love comes automatically, don't worry. Don't do anything to gain the love of that person. Do something to gain the respect of that person. So if I can truly say that my child respects me, my colleague in office respects me, my neighbor respects me, my spouse respects me, then I know that, yes, I am going on a path where I am going to have sustained relationships. Sustained relationships which are going to be sound, which are going to be based on a sense of, as I mentioned, trust, safety, and well-being. Even when you just love a person and you don't respect, no, that love gives you a lot of thrill, for example. That love gives you a sense of excitement, adventure, romance, if it's a man-woman love. But it does not give you that sense of trust, safety, and well-being, which is what we should look for. That is how this thing, goes. To have a healthy relationship, what are the factors? How is it that you build up that trust? What do I actually do at the practical day-to-day level? So I jotted down some points and Anis has made it into a nice little PPT. And here she's going to show you some very basic, very simple points which we use in day-to-day life and we should use in day-to-day life. Okay. Start with something as simple as be a good listener. When you value somebody, do you listen to that person without interrupting? Making a sincere effort to understand the other person's pure point of view, even if I don't agree. You can express your disagreement, but do you spend time listening and trying to understand? Are you honest, congruent? Are you transparent? Do you keep your promises and your commitments? The respect of that person goes up. Yes, if that person can say, I know that this one always keeps up to the word, always keeps up to commitments, promises. In today's world, mind you, people think it is okay to be late. It is okay to promise something and get away. In this world, tremendous respect can be gained if you are the type of person who keeps up to your word, who keeps up to your commitments. Now, all these things you have to actually express. How? By appreciating, acknowledging, telling the person in different ways, verbal and nonverbal, that I appreciate this aspect of you. I acknowledge that you have this great quality in you. And then one very important thing which we miss out sometimes, set boundaries and respect them. Probing into somebody's private affairs, however close that person may be, without permission, being suspicious, or not allowing any boundaries to have, clinging on to each other, not giving space, that is what causes loss of respect. So set boundaries and respect those boundaries, adhere to those boundaries. conflicts. Any close relationship will definitely have conflicts. You cannot get away. In fact, conflict is a means to say that you value this relationship. That's why you're fighting. That's why you're arguing. Because you want to resolve issues between us. If somebody on the road says something nasty to me, I don't even feel like, you know, getting into a conflict or reply to him. I will say, okay, pa, you are right. I'll walk off from there. So resolve conflicts in a constructive manner. See if you can support their goals and cheer their achievements. Can you do that? Can you say, this person who is dear to me or whom I regard very much has certain goals in life. They may not be in congruence with my goals. They may not help me in any way. They may, in fact, in some cases, take that person a little away from me because that person has certain goals which don't match with mine. Do I still have the broad-mindedness to cheer their achievements? Okay. Some more tips I'll give you on how to build this concept of respect in your close relationships. Express your needs, wants in a direct, calm, and respectful way. Sometimes we get carried away and we become satirical. You know, we crack jokes about something. We try to, you know, put something into a humorous way, but it actually hurts the other person. If you can express your needs and your wants directly, calmly, no, this I feel hurts me. This causes certain conflicts or problems to me. This is what I need from you. You are important to me. And if I get it from you, I'm going to be very thrilled. I'm going to be very happy if I get this from you. Respond in a timely manner if someone requests something. This is very, very important. I see people who are in a so-called close relationship. When they want something, they will call up the other person 10 times. But if the other person asks something, we tend to take it for granted. We don't even tell the person that I am busy. I can't do this for you right now. Give me time later or something. No. We just ignore. We think that because the other person knows us so well and is so close to us, that the other person will understand. But no, even if he understands, the respect goes down. If you want to build respect, you must follow these things. Acknowledge what the other person is doing well. Appreciate whatever the other person. I told you, a simple thing like punctuality. There are so many people around us who are just not punctual. If you have one close person who is very punctual, acknowledge. We just take it for granted. Yes, he was supposed to come here at 2 o'clock. He came. Within time, he came. Okay, fine. No. Acknowledge. Tell the person. Express it in whatever ways. Show your appreciation of it. Let people know that you appreciate them. That I like this fact that you are always punctual. I always appreciate that when you give your word, you stick to it. I'm really so happy and so grateful that you reach out and help in small, small ways whenever I need help. And in the same way, can you address mistakes with kindness? Yes, everybody makes mistakes. Sometimes those mistakes hurt you and irritate you also. But at that moment, can you control and manage your emotions and say, yes, this mistake has hurt me. Maybe you didn't intend. Maybe you didn't realize the extent to which I am hurt. Okay. So far we've been talking a lot about the things that we need to do in order to ensure that our relationship becomes respectful. And if you have noticed, if you see these things, maybe Anis will again run this through to you when we are winding up the session. You'll notice that these things go two ways. One is the way I build respect to the other person. I make the other person feel close to me. I appreciate, I acknowledge. I make the person feel warm and connected and loved. Equally important, if you go through that list once more, you will realize these are things which will help the other person to build respect towards you. That's equally important, no? One is appreciating the good things of people for which you respect the person. And if you look around, among the sea of humanity where there are so many hypocrites, so many people who just don't care about others' feelings, who are just climbing their own ladders, who are focused only on themselves, who don't mind hurting others or putting down others. In this sea of humanity, there are quite a few calm, quiet, silent people who deserve your applause, your appreciation, your acknowledgement. Can we do something about that? Can we make people think that this is what I do, for which I deserve your respect? Make it into a lifestyle. You can't do it with one person or two persons and say with the others, I'm not going to do it, because it becomes a personality trait. So if you make it into a habit, and let me tell you, in today's world of undefined relationships, you don't even know that in the coming days and coming years, who will be very close to you and who will not be. You may have very close blood relationships with whom you have a very good relationship, but they move to the other end of the world. They're busy in their own thing. They hardly have any time for you. Their lifestyle, their culture, their family, everything has changed. You can't depend on them. Similarly, you may have close relationships which deteriorate. So if you start using these tips and techniques that I have been telling you, there are people who may not be close to you, who may not be your very near and dear or your loved ones. But as they start noticing this, they come closer to you. They appreciate you. They have gratitude towards you and they have respect towards you. That is the way to ensure that relationships, which is the most important aspect of our well-being, is constantly nurtured. And because of that, even if one odd person hurts me, cheats me, or walks away from me, I know that I command enough respect that there will be other people who will look up to me, who will stand by me, who will hold my hand, and who will give me that support as and when I'm needed. Even if you don't actually need their support, just knowing that there are people around me who hold me in high regard, that itself is a great feeling. Try it out and see. If you can truthfully list out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people who you are sure that they hold you in high regard, they respect you, they may or may not agree with you on many things, but still they say, whatever it is, I still have that. If you read biographies of great people, no, you will inevitably find that there are so many great people who form close relationships with people whom they disagree with. The classic example is Mahatma Gandhi. There are innumerable people who loved Mahatma Ji, but they disagreed with him. Yet they had a very, very close bonding relationship. This is what helps us if we go into this, okay? Now, let me also, before we end this first half hour of the session, let me also tell you how to sustain this. See, somebody may have high regard or high respect, but over a period of time, it may deteriorate. Or the person may say, no, I think I made a mistake. So what do I do to ensure that these traits or this type of connect that I have with people who are important to me, they become long lasting. So here's one more list of some very simple practical tips which Anis is showing you right now. So as the title says, to strengthen on long-term basis, to strengthen this respect, this regard, this bond on a long-term basis, demonstrate trust. We make this mistake at times. We go and tell a third person that I respect A, B, C, whoever it is, unconditionally. I will do anything. I know that person will not cheat me. But have you told it to the person directly? Have you demonstrated by saying, here, I leave this in your custody because I trust you so much, I know you will take care of this. That is what we mean by demonstrating that trust. Be mindful of how you communicate. You know what happens in close relationships? We sometimes tend to take things easy. We don't really bother what we are saying, what is our body language, how we are responding. Somebody is talking and we just ignore that person, saying, oh, this person, I'll listen to him later, I'll talk to him later or something. But that is how the trust starts coming down, when the communication starts coming down, and then the respect starts coming down. I need not emphasize the third point, that is, be reliable and accountable. The buck stops with me. I feel so happy when anybody expresses that. Leave it to me. I will do it in whatever way it has to be done. Don't bother about it. I am accountable. I will see that the responsibility that has been put on me is never let down. You can rely on me. This has to be done both in terms of verbally expressing and also in terms of showing by your actions that I am reliable and I am accountable. Check with the person. Did you feel that what you trusted me with, I lived up to your expectations? And if the person says yes, that's a quick reminder to yourself and to the other person that you have become reliable, that you are accountable. The other thing is to encourage time apart. What they say is give space. Unless you give space to people, however harmonious the relationship is, sometime or the other, you start suffocating. You start getting too close to each other, and then you cannot breathe. If you go back to the famous quote or poem of Khalil Gibran, where he said that love each other, but do not touch each other, do not be dependent on each other. He says, two loving beings are like the two pillars of a temple which holds the roof. If those two pillars lean towards each other and come close to each other, the roof is going to collapse. So that, what is that roof? That roof is a good long-term relationship. That roof is an evidence of your well-being and leading a good quality of life. And that comes out of giving space. Check whether at any time you are becoming emotionally dependent, you are becoming clingy, you are pursuing the other person. In extreme cases, you see how they say, no, A is stalking B. What is stalking? That person, B, does not want you with him or her, but A continues to chase. B is going further and further, and A is also going faster and faster, trying to get close to B. That you should not allow. So any good relationship, if you have regard and if you have that trust, spend time away from each other. There was this joke that You know, a couple said that, oh, we have already planned out our summer vacation. My husband is going to the beach and I'm going into the hills. We are going to have a lovely time and come back. People are aghast. What sort of couple is this? But I tell you, that couple is laying the foundation for a good, strong, long-term relationship by encouraging time away from each other, by giving space to each other. You should appreciate your differences. Any close relationship, there are bound to be so many differences which you don't even realize. Let's start with the fact, if it's a man-woman relationship, men and women are built totally differently, not just physically, but also mentally and emotionally. If it is a parent-child relationship, there is a thing called generation gap. The way a parent thinks, the child can never think in that way. So there will be differences. You have a best friend, you have a sibling, you have whoever it is. You are not twins of each other. You are not mental twins. There are bound to be differences. And when there are differences, you must appreciate them. There's a proverb in management jargon which says, if an organization has two managers who agree on everything, throw out one of them. What is management? Management is decision making. If two of them keep taking the same decision, they agree on everything, why do you need to pay the salary to two people? One is more than enough. But the idea is that if there are two managers, they should disagree. They should argue. They should give counter arguments. They should have different opinions and ideas and then thrash it out. The same thing happens in personal relationships. Don't get upset over differences. Appreciate that you have differences. And lastly, get to know yourself. This is something which many of us, over a period of time at least, as we grow older, we tend to neglect. I know what I am. I am what I am. I know what is good and bad. You don't have to tell me. I am like this only. They, you know, in a lighter vein, they give this sort of quote about Indians. We are like this only, we say. Individually also, we do the same thing. I am like this only. I can't change. I can't do this. This is the way I have been. No. It's a continuous process and a continuous exercise to consciously getting to know yourself better and better and better. And this is not just in terms of your individual traits, but also in terms of your interpersonal traits. I have mentioned this to you, that we have certain qualities which I define as intrinsic qualities, which affect only me. And there are many other qualities or traits which are interpersonal. Those are the ones which affect others. Am I punctual in a meeting? Do I hold up to my commitment or my word? Do I cheat people? Do I look down upon people and, you know, make nasty remarks about them? Those are interpersonal traits. So continuously review your own self, your traits, particularly your interpersonal qualities, and that will ensure that you will be able to build respectful relationship continuously with your near and dear. Okay, so with that, I'll take my quick 2-minute break. Purnima is here, and I know that whenever she comes, a lot of you say, hi Purni, good, like, lovely, and all that. So you do that, and then I'll come back.
Am I on? I don't know, my spectacles, no, they start glaring. No, too much. Hi, good afternoon. Good afternoon. How are you all? Yeah, so good to receive pleasantries from you. Fantastic. And I think today's topic is also very powerful, no? Respect that builds a relationship. I think it's an excellent topic to have, because that creates a base for so many good things in life. And we keep telling everyone who comes for career, for counseling and everything, that the way things are moving, we will be living up to at least 85-90 years of age. And if we are going to be living up to 85-90 years of age, which means we better build relationships with our folks so that they have trust in us and take care of us well. So I think time to be selfish, okay? And they say, you know, give respect and take respect. So first, let's give it off and then take it from all of them. Good afternoon to each one of you. Good to get your, you know, nice wishes. And when we are talking of respect, I think our respect should also be to the different strata of the society, be it the adult or the youngster, the rich, so-called. I mean, rich or poor is all relative, no? So be it rich or be it young or whoever that be, poor, educated, uneducated. And in that one sector also come our children who may possibly be having special needs. So if you want to show, display your respect to them, or if you know anyone who is working in the arena or the area of special education, then this year we are organizing a special education seminar on the 6th of April from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. So this is our humble contribution, totally free service, okay? It is our humble contribution to those who are, you know, either parents or caregivers, they are teachers or they are doing, or institutions, whoever that they be, all these people who are in that area. So people who are directly, you know, connected with children with special needs, we are having a special education for the people who are in that area on the 6th of April. So what my request would be, that as a mark of our respect to those people, if you know anyone who is in that particular you know, field, then just give us a little heads up. So we will send the invite to them. We can interact with them, because this will be one common forum, you know, when everybody can meet. So there are parents, there are caregivers, there are teachers, there are people who are doing a lot of training. So all these people can come together. And when we are talking of relationships and we are talking of respect, one thing which comes immediately to my mind is the camp at Manthan, which we are going to be having. It is on relationships. You know, we get a lot of people who are, you know, talking of, oh, we should have emotional, you know, disconnect, and we should also have boundaries, and so many things are coming up. So we are going to be also addressing how to anticipate change in relationships and to respect those relationships. We are going to be, see, the poster is up there. So we are going to be having a camp at Manthan, which is going to be a very introspective, lecture-based, activity-based. Lot of good combinations are going to come up. So this is for you and for anyone who you think can benefit from the Manthan camp. We have limited seats, right? So we don't want you to be disappointed later. So please ensure that if you want to come, book up your seats in advance. And with that, for more respect in relationship, I'll call Ali for all your questions and his answers. Ciao. Ta-ta.
And I can see quite a few comments, questions. Anis will put them on one by one and I shall respond, starting with Asha. Respect does not necessarily mean that I trust. For me, it is you lay your cards, I will lay mine. Walking parallelly and staying detached. That's a good way of putting it, Asha. But at the same time, I would say that respect is very closely connected to trust. If you don't trust a person, would you respect that person? You said this person is not trustworthy. This person doesn't keep up to his words. This person cheats everybody. Can I then respect that person? So somewhere the connect does come in. Give it a thought. Divya says, I feel relationship is an emotional connect where we have expectations. Yes, definitely, no doubt about it. There's no relationship without expectations. Also, sometimes people will judge if we care or if we have more concern compared to others. Yes, people will definitely judge. But it's up to you to express that care, concern in whatever way that you can, isn't it? Mamta says, truly, no two individuals are alike, even twins. Yes, we need to respect the individuality of each person. This is something which I keep on telling my counselees and my students on a regular basis. People who say things like, you know, my parents don't understand me. No, you have two parents, right? And that too, one is a man and one is a woman. Even if they're married, even if they've been together for the last 50 years or more, they still have two independent minds. So never make the mistake of saying, my in-laws are like this only. All my cousins are like this. None of my neighbors is good. That is how you're creating walls. Never do that. Look at everybody individually. That is very important. I agree with Mamta. Lakshmi says, thanks so much, Ali sir, for such enlightening and empowering words. Most welcome, Lakshmi. And we shall continue this journey. Mamta also says, yes, knowing ourselves is a continuous process. And regular self-evaluation is quite important. And I repeat again, self-evaluation, not just in my intrinsic qualities, but also in my interpersonal qualities. Learn to differentiate between these two. Madhu is here. Yes, Madhu, welcome back. True, know yourself and love yourself first. Then only we can radiate around us and understand, respect each other. Yes, what Madhu says makes a lot of sense, no? Ask yourself, do you respect your own self? Can I say, yes, I have got many bad qualities. I do, you know, I'm not perfect. I do some bad things also. But still, I think I'm a good enough person. I'm a respectable person. And I do respect myself. It goes a long way in keeping your self-esteem intact. Surekha says, when we accept and respect differences, we nurture the self-esteem and self-worth of each other. This is very important. My self-worth, my self-esteem goes up. And by respecting the other person, I am boosting the other person's self-respect, self-esteem, self-worth. It's a win-win situation. We then help each other to grow into mature and independent individuals. As usual, Surekha comes out with something very, very touching. If you noticed, it is to grow as independent individual, not just as individuals. Because what we should aim for in all aspects of our life is to be independent. Never be dependent on somebody. The same way as we spent 100 years to make sure that as a country we become independent, this is the time for us to work towards individually being independent, right? Surekha also says, no. Yeah. Surekha says, not respecting each other's individuality and wanting harmony in a relationship is like trying to drive down the road with one foot on the accelerator and the other foot on the brake. Very well said, Surekha. That's what we land up doing, and we don't know whether the vehicle is going forward or the vehicle is stopping, or I'm just burning off the brake liners, after which I won't even be able to brake properly when I want. So many complications come out of that. And that's why we have to be careful and we have to follow these very simple, practical ways. Padma says, good afternoon, Ali, Purnima, Banjara. Banjara is always there to nurture relationship. Truly always upholding the values of relationship despite fast changing, uncertain demands. This I keep telling all of you, no? Changes are taking place not just in technology and artificial intelligence and data sciences. Changes are taking place in relationships. And do I keep myself abreast? Do I not only adapt to change, but do I anticipate what change is going to come in? Then I'm going to be a successful person in life. Roshan says, from my experience, I have seen that you gain respect only when you have prestige and position or financially rich. Nobody cares for your goodness or kindness. Everybody wants to be friendly only when you have a certain amount of wealth. My own sister has no respect for me as she is very wealthy. And here I am, a simple, ordinary person. My own son respects people with money. He has no respect for me as he knows with what difficulty I have brought them up. Very painful situation. So what do you do if you are in such a situation? Look for those people who are genuine. Your sister may not be genuine. Your son may not be genuine. They don't know the value of respecting people who do not have money, who do not have status or wealth, but who have character, who have values, who have compassion. Now, they may not respect you, doesn't matter. But believe me, if you look around, you will always find people who regard you, accept you, and love you, regardless of your financial status or any other status or what their relationship is with you. Surekha says, how do you respect the differences when a teenager wants to come home at 2 a.m. or when your mother-in-law wants to rearrange your house? Okay, what was I saying in the first part? It is not necessary that you will respect everybody. There would be somebody who is not worthy of your respect. Nothing wrong if you don't respect such a person. That's again an extension of what I was responding to Roshan also. That you may have a sister who doesn't care for you. You may have a mother-in-law who may be very negligent towards you. You may have a teenager who's so bindas, he says, I'll come home at 2 o'clock in the night. I'll do whatever I want. Now, those people, whatever you do, you may not have respect for them. Doesn't matter. Your relationship continues. Connect with them. Do whatever minimum you have to be them. But don't force yourself to respect the person. Respect has to come from within. And unless it happens from within, there's no point in trying to, you know, force yourself to respect and open out your mind and this and that. Let go. The world is so big. We have 8 billion people in this world. And the way communication and connectivity has improved, now you can connect to anybody in any part of the world. It's not just your neighbor or your, you know, relative or your locality person. In such a huge world, why do we still find it difficult to find genuine people to care for, to love, and to cherish relationship? It is because we don't make the right steps. If I learn to take those right steps, I can make a beautiful life for me and for the other person also. Lakshmi says, true form of respect is when we value and reciprocate one's feelings and emotions. Being emotionally healthy and mature and creating a conducive, healthy atmosphere for the beings around us is true respect. Very well put, Lakshmi. I will definitely agree with you. See, each one of us, if we put a thought, we come out with our own ideas, our own definitions, our own descriptions. And that is what I love. I don't like people who copy somebody's proverbs or somebody's definitions or somebody's ideology and go about repeating it. You should have a mind of your own. And a few things, like the way Lakshmi just now described what, you know, is true, you know, respect. I appreciate that. You don't necessarily have to agree 100% with whatever somebody else says, but learn from them. Surekha says, doesn't respecting the difference open our mind and our heart to new possibilities, new alternatives, and new options? Yes, I agree. To some extent, you can't do it indefinitely. If somebody is really being nasty, if somebody is very close-minded, don't keep hitting your head against a wall. As I told you, there are other fish in the pond. You can look for other people. But yes, as Surekha rightly said, we must make that effort at least, and sufficient effort in order to be clear to our conscience and say, yes, I tried everything. It didn't work. So now I'm going to slowly take two steps back in my relationship with this person. Roshan says, wherever I go, people say that I have a stamp of trust on my face and makes me feel good. And I have to keep up to their expectations. It makes me work better and harder. Here, Roshan, you answered your own question. People are not appreciating you because of your wealth or status or whatever it is. They're appreciating you for the fact that you are trustworthy. Isn't that great? Now, you yourself have found a way. Now, you need not be, you know, in close connection with people who are only respecting position, status, power, wealth, or whatever. Let them lead their own lives. How are we bothered? We shall find the right people around us. Kumar Swami, yes, Namaste Ali, Purnima, and Team Banjara. Ali, can you please throw light on how to maintain relationships and the true connect with family members? Even though both of us know we are not respecting each other so much by the heart, especially in front of our children. No, forget about being in front of your children or not. You work on your own relationship, be it with your partner, be it with your parent, be it with your sibling, whatever it is. Be genuine and work on it, not just to show off to your children or to put a, you know, positive image before your children. Do it for yourself. Do it for the person whom you genuinely care for or you're going to spend the rest of your life with. There are so many things. I've in fact written a very exhaustive book on relationships in which I cover all these aspects. It's available in Banjara, both hard copy and soft copy. If anybody wants, just get in touch with the office, talk to Venu, and he will give it to you and he'll tell you whatever the pricing or whatever the thing is. But do give more and more importance to all aspects of relationships. Lakshmi says, when a person addresses another person by calling them G, but makes him feel constantly unworthy by sidelining his emotions, this situation is very confusing. How do you deal with this kind of scenario? Yes, Lakshmi, these are the people whom we call as hypocrites. They will smile at you, they will bow down at you, and then they will criticize you and they will say things to you. I had a very nasty friend during my student days. Whenever he wanted something from an elder person, he would go to him and he would say, Kaka. You know, Kaka is uncle, a very respectful form of calling a person, you know, as a respected person, by saying Kaka. So he would say, Kaka, mera ye kaam kar do. Kaka, please do this. Kaka, this, that. And the elder person would feel flattered that, see, this youngster is coming and asking, and he would go out of the way. As he's turning around, he would say, Vakt pade banka, to gadhe ko kahe kaka. That was his philosophy of life. He didn't do very well in life. He's a miserable person. I don't even meet him these days, but what I hear from other friends and all that, He tried so much to take advantage of everybody that he could not ever build strong, worthwhile relationships. Surekha says, respecting the differences makes us less possessive and judgmental. Very true, I agree with you. It makes us more trusting, more giving, less selfish, and less defensive in our interactions with others, because you are respecting the differences. You are acknowledging and accepting the differences, and then only can you respect those differences. This is what we have to learn through a continuous process. Madhu says, respect doesn't come for such people who betrayed you as husband, sons, but you carry on, do your responsibility. Be with them, don't demand, but you never give up because you love them. Times change and you will fulfill your goals and be happy for that. Respect them as human. That's a very nice way of putting it. Just respect them as human beings, not as your spouse or your son or your colleague or your whatever it is, not because the person is good in this or bad in that or whatever it is. Understand that every human being has been made by the Creator. If somebody is good, somebody is bad, somebody is good to me, but he is bad to somebody else and vice versa. Learn to respect that, okay? Madhu says, you learn a lot from such broken relationships. That's up to us, Madhu. If we develop that temperament and that attitude, that whenever there is a broken relationship or a strained relationship or a letdown in relationships, can I look at it in the manner where I say, this is a learning. This is a step towards better relationships. If I take up that attitude, review and say, what happened? I got hurt. I got cheated. I got let down by somebody. So what is the lesson that I have learned? And from there I can go on happily. Surekha says, how does being open-minded and easygoing help to build harmonious relationships? I would like to caution Surekha and all of you, in fact, that you need not always be open-minded and easygoing. Be a little selective. We are already there, but if we can do that in a more systematic manner. I'm not going to be easygoing with somebody who I have doubts on. I will not have an open mind which is so open that people walk in and take advantage of me. So learning whom to trust, whom not to trust. Whom to trust to what extent and whom to trust in what areas of interactions. Those are the skills which ensure that we go towards a good quality of life. Roshan says, people don't respect when one suffers from a mental illness. So much of humiliation and disrespect from society that you have to prove that you too are human like others. Yes, Roshan, I agree. I have seen so many people suffering because of that. My only request to you is you use the word people. People can be 10, 100, 1,000, 1 lakh, 1 crore, 100 crores. Out of the people around you, please look for those who don't care whether you have a mental illness, whether you are a pauper, whether you are bad looking, whether you have no status in life. They still give unconditional love. There are such people around. Look for them. And we have Mamta. I think that's the last comment that we have. Very insightful and heart-touching session. Thank you, Ali, for your tremendous energy and knowledge. Put it in all in the sessions. As always, today's session was very educative and thoughtful. Thank you very much. And I think Mamta has reflected my own sentiment. Thanks to all of you who participate in this, particularly those of you who put up your comments, questions, doubts, disagreements. I learned so much from all of you. And as Madhu says in the end, gratitude, Ali. I learned a lot from Banjara only. Never knew anything about emotional disorder. Thank you. Yes, pranam to you also, Madhu, and to all of you. Have a wonderful day and weekend ahead. I shall be meeting you again next Saturday, which is going to be the 10th of February. And Anis is putting up the topic for you. Have a look at it. And if you want, have a look at the points which I had said last. The topic for next Saturday on 10th February is get rid of childhood baggage. This I have taken up because very often I come across people who carry that childhood baggage into their adult life, and it affects their adult life very badly. So I'm going to be reviewing and helping you to think, if you have any childhood baggage which you have not been able to get rid of, how to get rid of it and how to move on briskly by unburdening yourself. So thank you and bye-bye.
Once you know the game, then all that people is being able to do it. If you have a problem, you also carry the time to get the people. Just like that. Unless that they have done wrong, that's a good thing. Yeah. So, what is the problem? Yes. Do you know what? No.